Hi, my name's Guy, and let's get into this video because there's a lot of things to talk about. So let's get started. So, sometimes in life, especially if you don't follow in God or you don't believe in Him, life is tough. Life is very stuck. But you should always do what you like. This verse I'm gonna read is in Corinthians from, I got this from Caitlin Price. But right now it's Caitlin Williams because she's not married yet. So yeah. But I hope you like this view. I want to have people who are more Christians and like more Christian views, not just for people who, I know you guys won't watch it, but I want to do more for people who want to do watch them, not just people who don't really care, don't like them, you know? I'm not just doing these for you, but it's also good because I need to go back and really read them. I said, Isaiah 18:10. Then the Lord said, I will CERTAINLY turn to ye about this time. A year from now, at the that time, your wife Sarah will have a son. For me, before I was Christian, I was not living for the Lord, and I didn't know him, but I didn't know what he did or what he, or anything like that. I was just living for myself, mostly boys. I know it's not right, but now I'm a Christian and I'm going to live for the Lord, and that's not all, you know, it's about God. I'm hoping that you guys want to do it too, not just me, you know? If you have any questions about being Christian or anything, just let me know. Don't be afraid to ask, because I want to do things that please you. It's like the wind. You can't feel the wind, but you still can feel God. You feel the wind, but you can't hear it. That's kind of like God. You can hear Him, but you can't feel Him. It says, Isaiah 8:22. As long as the earth continues planting and harvesting, cold and hot, summer and winter, days and night will not stop. I'm not talking about if you see my bed, don't worry about it. There's a lot in my life going to do once in a while. This devotion says, a little white lie. I said, Adam had opened God. He was falling and praying, living the life. You know, being the super adding off to EGYPT to find more dredges. The food shortage was problem number one. Other issue was there. Good looking. And it says, she was beautiful and Adam was freaked out. The issue was S-L-A-U-G-H-T-E-R me in a second to get their hand on the pretty wife. He thought so inches of going to God for assistance or attack. He come up with the old Billy Peter Pan lie about her identity. He found out it was just I-S-A-B-L-E because after all she was like watching TV and stuff. Buying half sister. She just C O N V E N I E T L Y weave out the death field, the death do us part bit, even if it was T E R E T I C A L Y A Y. Sure, it was a harm to write. A little white lie to save your own hide never hurt anyone, did it? As the king of Israel and his whole house, what they think about that was from terrible. Or as Sarah, as she take up R-E-I-D-E-N-C-E. And the hammer of forgetting king. Can you see me cry? That worked a little bit. Household, what they think about that has they served from table, or as there as she take up in a harm as Abram as he face a relationship with his God. They tell you that a half truth is no truth at all. When it comes to honest, it all or nothing. Amend yourself to speak the truth, and the whole truth is nothing but the truth, and even during the family of your life. I just talked about the last thing. If you are hiding something, or if you, make sure you tell the truth. Maybe is it just your parents, maybe it's your brother, maybe your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your fiance. Whatever it is, you should always tell the truth, because if you don't, how are they going to trust you? If you break their trust, how are they going to trust you? Because I did this to my parents, and that's not good. As we read Genesis 10:14.
see you lift me up, see how you dance. I'm gonna talk about a baby stare.
Cause it's some people are pregnant right now or want to be pregnant. This is a good story about Sarah's baby. So it says a baby for Sarah. Okay, guys, it says the Lord cares for Sarah as she has said and did for her what he had promised. Sarah became pregnant and gave birth to son Abram in his old age. Everything happened at the time God had said it would. Abram's name had son Isaac. The son Sarah gave birth to, he circumcised Isaac when he was 8 days old. Wow, 8 days old, that's crazy. God had commanded Abram was 1 year old when Isaac was born. And Sarah said, God has made me laugh. Everyone who hears about this will laugh with me. No one through that I would be able to have Abram child, but even through Abram is old, I have give him a son with him too. In this way we can use our father to have children to continue our family. So that night they have their father drink again. That means beer, wine, whatever you want to say. And Elon's daughter went and had a sexy relationship, like, you know what I'm saying, with him. Again, Lot did not know when they lay down or when she got up. So both all the daughters became pregnant by their father. Ew. That makes me sick. By the same father, it's like say my dad has 2 daughters and I get pregnant with my dad and same as the other daughter. That makes me sick. The older daughter gave birth to a son named Moab, and I heard it before. He is the ancestor of the Moabite people who are still living today. The long daughter also gave birth to a son named Ben Ammi. He is the father of all Ammonite people who are still living today. The one who killed me to get Sarah, and it is true that she is my sister and she is my daughter of my father, but she is not my daughter of my mother. When God told me to leave my father,